Mr. Martin, the drugs.
Yes.
The drugs is here to stay. The cat will never get rid of the drugs. The drugs is a big crisis.
But tell me this, Davey, right? Real. Say, for instance, you did legalise the drugs, but you had to have, you still had to have certain things. You had to be a certain age. You had to be at a certain stage, blah, blah, blah. But they brought the price right down to rock bottom. The crims would interested, and the crims would do a runner. So once the crims have done a runner, you know, do you think people would say, ach, I don't bother with that stuff anymore. It's just doing my head in.
What I've done, I've travelled the world years ago. Seriously, I've been to Amsterdam as a free country with drugs.
Uh-huh. And do you think that's worked out a lot better for them?
Aye and no, but it's still dangerous.
I like the aye and no. The only thing is, if it's a free country for it, are the crims not still supplying them?
Of course they are.
Well,
son,
that's your thing,
yes,
you see what I mean?
I mean, I used to walk along Amsterdam canals and go to certain areas with my ex-partner.
Uh-huh.
And all of a sudden, I've been a clothes shop in the Scottie in Amsterdam. You go in the lift, there's drug dealers in the lift trying to grab you. Say, do you want this or do you want that? You're trying to get away from them. I'm serious, right? You're trying to get out the shop and run down a pathway. And then one night, a guy put a gun right out, right in front of me and my boyfriend. Anyway, so the police intercepted him. I'm serious, right?
We
had to run for our life, Scotty. And he was just trying to say, take cocaine. You should buy cocaine. You should buy this, buy that. And Scotty was dead scary.
Well, listen, you don't want that, Davey. You know what I mean? You're better just a nice night at the pictures and a poke of chips, you know?
Of course, and again, you know, you just got gay bars in Amsterdam, that was fine. But, you know, they've got hash shops in Amsterdam, hash shops everywhere, coffee shops, hash menus, hash cakes, all over. It's actually legal there.
Yes.
But they've still got a law against the people who are selling drugs in the street who are gangsters.
Yes, yes. Well, I think that's the problem. It's the criminal involvement.
Yep. I mean, I'm not going to lie to you. One night I was in a gay club in Amsterdam, and this man came in and he said to me in Dutch language, hello or something.
Hello or something.
So, my boyfriend was in another bar having a laugh with his pals, and then the guy pulled out this box and it was full of joints.
See, I think though, Davey, things have changed in that in those days, gay men used to be very, very worried about the law, about being caught, about being charged, blah, blah, blah. Now, all that's gone now, and that must surely be a huge advance.
Well, of course, but I mean,
you know?
see, on a gay sense planet, drugs are rife, my friend.
Yes. Yes. I mean,
it's
a big problem.
Rife.
I mean, it's interesting though. I think a lot of the bringing up Scotland's drug difficulties and drug problems, of it's political because
Parliament.
It'll be just the same in all the English towns and cities and in London. So I think using the drugs thing is political to say, oh yes, the SNP have got the highest have presided over a Scotland with the highest, you know, and then they need to start saying, whoa, let's just analyse that comment and compare it with Manchester, with London, with Birmingham, see how we go, you know.
Right, Scotty, but judges in Scotland and all other judges who come to a murder case and a court case, etc., or any cases, judges are hard. They have to wake up morning and send somebody down for like 22 years for murder. Now, a lot of judges take cocaine, Scotty, and
yes,
their
yes,
life.
Yes, no, listen, I'm not going to go into that, but I do agree that it
I
is
know,
widespread
yeah.
and it is across the social spectrum.
Yeah, because my ex was a lawyer, a top lawyer in Glasgow. He trained me everything about back in the day in the 90s. I'm serious. Yes. Judges are hard. 22 years for murder.
Yes, absolutely. But they are
stressed out. They're stressed out to the limit. Of course. All these criminals coming in.
Yeah, but they're also officers of the law. And I think that the bulk of criminals realize that system is there. And if they mess up, they will have to answer to it.
Of course.
You know, David, as always, your calls are amazing. And I say to you, dinky do.
I love you, my friend.
Ta-da, la-la. That's good, David. Yes, and interesting. Very, very interesting. Now,